Selam. Yelts ladder. So when to use Yelts ladder now? Yelts ladder means what and when to use it now? See here. Please concentrate all. Now suppose we have list of conditions. We have list of conditions that is more than one. List of conditions means what? More than one. We have list of conditions. All must be checked. All must be checked consecutively. So just one after another. All must be checked just one after another. Another in sequence. And these are such conditions. Out of them, only one condition may becomes true. Out of them, only one condition may becomes true at a time. Condition may becomes true at a time. So what is the situation here? First, point to be note, we have list of conditions. Okay, that is more than one. All must be checked just one after another. And out of them, only one condition may becomes true at a time. Means we have list of conditions. We have, suppose this is the first condition, first part. Suddenly the first part, after first part, we have to check second part. And after second part, we have to check third part. After third part, we have to check fourth part. Okay. Suddenly means just one after another means we have sequence of conditions. These conditions are must be checked just one after another in a sequence. Okay, so here suppose this is the first condition. If it is checked and if it is not satisfied means become false, then second condition will be checked. If it is not satisfied, become false, then third condition must be checked. Okay, so and if one of them is satisfied, suppose for example, if second condition becomes satisfied, then third should not be checked, fourth should not be checked. Like that, we have list of conditions. Out of them, only one condition may becomes true at a time. In such case, just use Yelts ladder. So Yelts ladder means what here? So we are going to write second condition in else of first if. That is the Yelts ladder. We are writing second condition in else of first if. Okay, so that is the Yelts ladder. Yeah, pardon. When we have to use, we have to check sequence of conditions. Out of them, only one condition may becomes true. We have sequence of conditions. Out of them, only one condition may becomes true. In such case, else if ladder is used. Following is a general form. In such case, else if ladder is used, and following is a general form of else if ladder. So what is the general form of else if ladder? See, the if form condition. Of else if ladder like this. See, if and here we are writing condition number one. Okay, and here the program lines. Here the program lines. So obviously what happened? when it occurs in program, program control will check the condition. Program control will check the first condition, and if this first condition becomes true, then and then program lines those present in first condition part will be run. If first condition becomes true, then and then program lines those present in first condition, okay, so will becomes what we can say will become executed, will be executed, we can say. So when condition becomes true, yes, and if it is not true, then obviously program code comes to the else part. If first condition is not becomes true, then obviously program code comes to the else part, and in else here we are writing second condition, that is a condition number 2. We are writing what here? Condition number 2. So we are checking that condition. Okay, so condition number 2 is present in else, it's present in else, and again one point to be note here. So there is a space in between the else and if. Means actually we are adding if statement in else here. What is happening? We are adding if statement in else. Actually we have to write like that here. See, we have to write like this. So this is a else, and in this else we are writing, in this else means this is a else opening curly brace and else closing curly brace. In this else here we are writing second condition. The second condition will be checked when first condition become false. Second condition will be checked when first condition become false. Why? Because when first condition become false, then program code comes to the else part. Program code else comes to the else part, and inside else there is a second condition. Means as the nature of the statement occurs, the program control will be execute that statement. Means will be run that statement. So here there is a single if statement here. Actually, if you started with the alphabet if and ends with a closing curly brace, so here there is a single statement. That is why I am going to cut it. Okay, I am going to cut like that, and I am going to write like this here. So actually what is happening, this is a if statement. This if statement is present inside else of first if. So else is of first if. So ha else konacha ahe, pahila if cha else ahe, and the else madhe if statement hai. Suppose second condition also becomes true, also become false, then what we have to do, so means in this case what happened, program code comes to the third condition, means the program code comes to the else of that second condition. Program control comes to the else part of that second condition. So this is else part of the second condition, and in this else also here, suppose there is another condition. If like this, this is a condition number 3. Okay, and this is the opening curly brace of if, and here program lines here like that, and here closing curly brace of if. Okay, so in this way, just else if, that number of, so how many conditions you are having, that number of else if you have to write, and at the end just say only and only else. At the end just say what? Only else without any if. Okay, so how it is going to be run? Yes, so initially when it is occurs in program control obviously checks the condition, means condition number 1. If it becomes true, then program lines those present in if block of first condition will be run. Program lines those present in if block of first condition will be run. Okay, so and then what happen? Else never run, and inside this else, this is the second if present, and this else means third else. Okay, second else is present in the second if, means actually this else is of this if. Okay, and obviously this if never executed means obviously else never executed. Means ha jo else ahe ha if cha ahe. Okay, tyach prakare ha jo else ahe tyacha varcha if cha asel. So jar ha else run hot nahi yacha artha kay, purcha ekahi condition check hot nahi hai, karan ki purcha sagla part jo ahe to else madhe ahe. Okay, next part of the next part of that chain, okay, is present in else, that is why it will never be executed. What happens when condition become false? Condition become false, the program control obviously comes to the else part, and here it will check the second condition, that is the condition number 2. When condition number 2 becomes true, then program lines those present in that condition number 2 block will be run. Otherwise, program control transfer to the else. Okay, and in else there is again third condition, and that condition will be checked, and so on. Means what happened? Second condition will be checked only when first condition become false. Third condition will be checked only when second condition become false, and so on. Okay, so what about the else here? This last else, will be run when? When this last else will be run? When all conditions become false. If suppose we have the situations and all of the conditions are become false, then definitely program control comes to the else, and in last else there is no if. That is why directly program controls are going to be program control will run program lines those present in else last else block. So in this way, here there is a else if ladder used in our C++. Okay, and the same concept is available in our C also. Yes. So in what situation we have to check? So suppose we have to use else if ladder in what situation? Suppose I have to check number is positive, negative, or zero. So how many sides are there? There are 3 sides like this one. So this is a side for the positive, this is a side for the negative, this is a side for the zero. And at a time, okay, there will be only one side. At a time, there will be only one side in front. Okay, or at the bottom. This only one condition may becomes true. If it is positive, then that number will never be negative and will never be zero. Means if it is greater than zero, then how is it possible it is zero? No. So why we are checking the condition? If it is positive, then why we are checking the condition for the negative? Actually, the situation is what here? So we have sequence of conditions, but these conditions are totally opposite. Totally opposite. If first becomes true, that means definitely and definitely second will never becomes true and third will never becomes true. So why are you checking the condition, second condition and third condition? If you are writing only if and here, opening curly brace, closing curly brace, and second if here, opening curly brace and closing curly brace, and third if and here, opening curly brace and closing curly brace, then what happened? Unnecessary program control will check the second condition and third condition when first condition becomes true. As a programmer, I have the responsibility to avoid the unwanted execution of my program, to avoid the unwanted execution of the program lines. Okay, so if my program control is busy in checking of conditions, then it is a totally wastage of time. It is a totally what? Wastage of time. That is why, what can I do? I am programmer and I know the sense of the that program and nature of that program. If first condition becomes true and if program lines present in the first if block get executed, then definitely second should not be there and third should not be there. That is why I can say just bypass the checking, just ignore the checking. Why are you checking and why are you waste of time, what we can say, program execution time. Totally become wastage. Why? Because it will check and definitely condition will become false because these are the totally opposite conditions. Totally opposite conditions. This is one of the scenario. Positive, negative, or zero. So positive means greater than zero. Negative means what? Less than zero. And zero means double equal zero. If first condition becomes true, then why are you checking the second condition? Why are you checking the third condition? Totally wastage of time. Avoid it. Avoid it. If first condition become false and then check the second condition, and if second condition becomes true, then why are you checking the third condition? Just avoid it. This is a main concept. This is a main concept. Okay. So this is a part. Just write on this syntax. Second syntax, you get like condition number 2, condition number 3, all of you. Shrutika syntax lihun ghetla, Sanjeevni?
Ho sir.
Reshma? Dhanishri? Lihun ghetla Dhanishri?
Yes sir.
Okay, Dhiraj?
Yes sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. So I'm going to execute. I'm going to show you a program. So suppose this is the same scenario, positive, negative, or zero. How can we write the program? See, directly I'm showing you in my software. You'll get understand. Wait a minute, it's an important call.
Sorry. Assalamu alaikum. Good evening, sir. I'm in my class, I'm in my class program. So, I'm going to come to the chat. हाँ मैं आऊंगा आऊंगा 8 बजे 8:15 बजे तक वहां पर पहुंच जाऊंगा नमाज आपके ईशा की नमाज के बाद हाँ ठीक है ठीक ठीक है ठीक
चलो नाउ जस्ट राइट ऑन द प्रोग्राम आई से इंक्लूड iostream.h फाइल इंक्लूड iostream.h फाइल then kunio.h file then here declare the number variable and just say cout and just say enter number okay and scene here number now here compare so how we can compare see if number is greater than 0 so what I say cout It is positive.
Positive.
It is positive number. If it is not greater than zero, then I have to check it for the negative. If number is less than zero, yes. So what I have to check here? It is. I have to produce it is negative. It is negative number. And again, if I am writing here, if number is equals to zero, then I have to check, and I have to produce it is zero. Just try to understand the execution sequence of this program. That is a p9.cpp. Already, so p10.cpp. And if you're sincerely attempting all the programs and if you're sincerely writing all these programs, then you will get a good collection of the program during our class. So compile success. Now see here, enter number. This message is going to be produced. Okay. So P10, I'm going to close this unwanted window and also this one unwanted window. Okay, so scene when scene statement executed, then what happened? It is reading the number I say 20. So it is checking the first condition. Now see here what is happening. It is checking first condition, that is 20 greater than 0. Condition becomes true. Condition becomes true, and it runs what C out. So we get the output. It is positive number. So as a programmer, what is the sense now? Tell me. The sense is that second should be false and third should be false. Yes or no? Yes. So now here program control is checking the second condition because you can see here the highlight is at a second condition. That is why here it is checking the second condition. Condition become false. Now program control comes to the third condition and it is checking the third condition. And so end of the program. So yeah, program the काय झालं माहिती का? Condition number 2 and condition number 3 व्यर्थ चेक करत बसले गेला. व्यर्थ चेक झाला. त्या चेक करण्यासाठी काही ना काही टाइम लागेल ना सो रिअल टाइम सिनेरियो सांगतो इन रिअल टाइम सपोज देर आर हंड्रेड्स ऑफ कंडिशन्स हाऊ मेनी कंडिशन्स टू बी चेक हंड्रेड्स ऑफ कंडिशन्स अँड ऑल दीज आर द कंडिशन्स सच अ वे दॅट ओनली वन कंडिशन विल बिकम्स ट्रू ॲट अ टाइम सपोज फर्स्ट कंडिशन नंबर कंडिशन नंबर 1 बिकम्स ट्रू सपोज इज इट नेसेसरी टू चेक द रिमेनिंग 99 कंडिशन्स If we are checking the 99 conditions, remaining 99 conditions, then our processor will be okay, busy in only checking of condition. That is a totally wastage of time. Yes. So in this case and in this scenario, I can use else if like this. Else if and here else if. Now in third else, we can see there is again if is used. So actually, sense point of view, logical point of view, if you are checking the number for the greater than zero, then you are checking the number for the less than zero, then at the end, it is not necessary to check the number for equal zero. Okay. So directly you can say else. What happened now? See here in this case, see, same again, I'm going to repeat now. So it is see here, it is directly executing the file, it's iostream.h. Now I say 25. 25 is greater than zero. Yes. See how it executed. And now you can check out here. Directly program code comes to the where? Gate.ch. Means what? In this case, it never checks any unwanted conditions. It never checks what? Condition number 2 and condition number 3. When condition number 2 will be checked? Now suppose I am going to input the value like this. So minus 10. So just cut that A. Minus 10. So minus 10, is it less than 0? Is it greater than 0? No. So else if. Is it less than 0? Yes. Then it shows the it is negative number and program code directly comes to the where gate.ch. Why? Because second condition becomes true. Second condition becomes true, then program code will never execute else part of that second condition. And so that it directly come out from that chain. So this is the purpose of the else if ladder. Else if ladder is used in these cases. Huh? Just keep in mind. We have to check number of conditions, consecutive conditions. And these conditions are such conditions, only one becomes true at a time. Okay, just write on this program. Program to check number is positive, negative or zero. लिहून झालं तर यस 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 कमेंट करा मला. ओके ठीक आहे. यस बोला
सर. आता सपोज मी तिथं कंडिशन दिली इफ नंबर इज ग्रेटर दॅन इक्वल्स टू तर मग सर पॉझिटिव्ह नंबर तर डिस्प्ले होणार. मग सर आपला एल्स पार्ट डिस्प्ले
नाहीच होणार ना. तिथपर्यंत जाणारच नाही प्रोग्राम कंट्रोल. नाही होणार, नाही होणार. का माहितीये का? ग्रेटर दॅन इज इक्वल्स टू म्हटलं. ऐका जरा, ग्रेटर दॅन इज इक्वल्स टू म्हटलं तुम्ही है ना, तर इथे काय होणार आहे सांगा बरं. पहिली व्हॅल्यू जर तुम्ही इनपुट केली सपोज 10, तर कंडिशन ट्रू होते का? अच्छा, पहिली व्हॅल्यू जर तुम्ही इनपुट केली, व्हॅल्यू जर इनपुट केली सपोज 0, कंडिशन ट्रू होते का? पहिली होते
ग्रेटर देन 0 होत सर तेच म्हणते मी जर ग्रेटर देन इक्वल्स टू दिलं आणि सपोज माझे इनपुट जर 0 असेल
हो तेच म्हणतो ना मी माझं तुम हे बघा ग्रेटर देन इज इक्वल्स टू द्या तुम्ही आणि तुमचं इनपुट 0 आहे तर तुम्ही चेक करा ना स्वतः तुम्ही स्वतः कंपाइलर बना ना थोड्या वेळासाठी आणि चेक करा काय होतंय पहिली आता पहिली कंडिशन ट्रू होली तर एल्स रन होणार आहे का नाही मग पुढचा पार्ट कधीच येणार नाही इट इज 0 कधीच येणार नाही ऍज अ प्रोग्रामर यू हॅव द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी की तुम्हाला कंडिशन अशा मॅनेज करायच्यात है ना बोलो ओके नाउ सो नाउ आता व्हेन टू यूज इफ अँड व्हेन टू यूज इफ एल्स आय विल शो यू वन इन वन एक्झाम्पल बिफोर दॅट अगेन वन ऑफ द एक्झाम्पल फॉर दिस एल्स इफ लॅडर सो ओके so now here we are going to write a program to identify the day of week so I will input day number so day number if I enter 1 then it should produce output what monday if I input suppose day number 2 then it should produce output what
tuesday
like that welcome Shushtudhar Have you late joined? So, three. Yes, Wednesday. Yes? So like 4. Thursday. Then 5. Friday. 6. And 7. So, you are inputting at a time how many numbers down tell me suppose I say enter then how many numbers can you input at a time only one suppose if you say 3 then which condition becomes true
third
Wednesday. If you are checking conditions from top to bottom suppose like this then Monday become false Tuesday become false and Wednesday becomes true Why are you checking these conditions? Just ignore. So here we can use else if. We can use else if. Okay. So I can input day number. I can input day number 4. I can input day number 5. I can input day number minus 1 also. If I say minus 1 or if I say 0 or if I say 20, if I say 8, then in these cases what should be there wrong input wrong input so how we can write program for this now a very 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 simple so here p11.cpp 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 okay so enter day number I say day num, enter day num, so like this here, and I'm going to write here condition, I'm going to check the condition, is equals to 1, what, day num,
yeah.
What, day num, no, okay, so if day num is what, 0, if day num is, 1, then I have to produce, today is,
Monday.
Today's Monday. I would like to produce output like this. So how many statements are there to be run when condition becomes true? So there is only one statement is a condition. Okay. That is why you can ignore to write this curly brace and this curly brace also. You can ignore to write. But better practice to use them. Better practice for avoid confusions. Day num. Just check out day num. Denum. So here denum is equals to if denum is equals to what?
2.
Then today is please mute yourself. Please all of you mute yourself. Tuesday. T-U-E-S-T-A-Y. Tuesday. Similarly like this I can say denim is equals to I say denim. I am going to copy and paste now. Denim is equals to 3. Today is WED, yani SDAY, Wednesday. So denim is equals to 4. Today is THRUSDAY, Thursday. If denim is equals to 5, then I can say today is Friday. And if denim is equals to 6, I can say today is Saturday. And if denim is equals to 7, then I can say today is Sunday. And if denim is not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then at the end, last case, wrong day number. So in this way we can write the program. Just run. Enter day number 4. It is displaying only Thursday. Just run. Enter day number 0 and it is displaying wrong day number. In case of 0, what happened? All conditions become false. First condition become false. That is why program control goes to the second condition. Become false. That is why program control goes to the third condition. Become false. Why program control goes to the next condition? Because program control will run else. And inside else, there is a if. Whatever present inside else to be run. Just keep in mind. Yes. Now again, one point to be clear. In this else, remaining chain is there. Huh? This one chain. Okay. This one complete remaining chain is present in else of first if. In else of second if, which one? In else of second if, remaining complete remaining chain is there. Means else never executed. That means what? It will never check any condition. So else not executed. That means it will never check any condition. So like that. So write on this program, all of you. Any problem now? Tell me. Now unmute yourself and tell me.
No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
कारण की आठवड्यातून कोणता तरी एक दिवस एकदा असतो. लक्षात घ्या, दोन दोन दिवस एकाच वेळी नसतात. आज सोमवार पण आहे, मंगळवार पण आहे, असं होत नाही. आज फक्त एकच कोणता तरी वार असतो. दॅट इज वाय वी कॅन यूज एल्स इफ. नाउ हियर वी हॅव 7 साइड्स अँड आउट ऑफ देम ओनली 1 साइड कॅन बी फ्रंट ॲट अ टाइम. Can be front at a time. Only one side. Either Monday, either Tuesday, either Wednesday, either Thursday. Like that. अच्छा, मला आन्सर द्या. आपल्या बॅच मध्ये किती जणांनी फीस डिपॉझिट केलेली अकाउंटला?
मी केले सर.
काय नाव तुमचं?
संजीवनी पाटील.
अच्छा, किती पे केले तुम्ही?
3000.
अच्छा, अकाउंट? SBI
नाही, ऍक्सिस बँक मध्ये.
ऍक्सिस बँक ला?
हा.
अकाउंट नेम व्हेरीफाय केलं?
नाही सर.
अकाउंट नेम व्हेरीफाय केलं होतं की नाही तुम्ही? SISP इन्फोटेक म्हणून?
नाही.
अच्छा, तुमच्याकडे कन्फर्मेशन सक्सेस वाला आहे का?
हा आहे की आहे माझ्याकडे.
अच्छा, तेवढं पाठवून द्या मला. अकाउंट नेम नंबर व्हेरीफाय करत जा कधीही डिपॉझिट करताना.
हो सर.
ए मम्मी कहने का
शिशुधर म्यूट म्यूट फ्रॉम योर साइड एंड देन टॉक write on properly all these conditions Sanjeevni Patil I received your amount huh?
Yes
okay so whenever you are going to pay through online pay kelega
and sir bank madhe jaun
okay tar tyas kay karaycha bank madhe jaun pay kela na tar apli je receipt asto na te receipt chi photocopy patvaychi thik hai whatsapp la म्हणजे कन्फर्मेशन असतंय समोर ओके थँक्यू अगेन ऑन अदर पीपल्स नाही केली आता उद्या तर संडे आहे यू कॅन पे ऑनलाईन ऑल्सो इफ आर युजिंग नेट बँकिंग देन यू कॅन पे ऑनलाईन धीरज सृष्टीधर
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir.
Okay. So I will finish your class, and I will conduct so many different programs. झालं का लिहून सगळ्यांचं हे प्रोग्राम?
झालं सर.
Okay. So ठीक आहे मी अपेक्षा करतोय सगळ्यांचं लिहून झालंय. So now again just discuss now your program to check oblique identify age status So we are inputting age, and if our age is in between 1 to 10, then we can say the status is child. 11 to 20, then we can say the status is what here? Teen. Then 21 to 40, we can say status is young. Okay. So YOUNG, young. So youngest mothast ka young mothast sanga bro. मोठ कोण असत कांबळे
तर यंग अँड यंगेस्ट आर सेम ओनली
तर हम किसको इसमें नाम क्या देंगे फिर यंग से बड़ा
हो गया सर सबसे पहले तो यंग रहेगा टीन रहेगा नहीं सबसे पहले सर यंग रहेगा इन्फेंट रहेगा सर इन्फेंट फिर यंग रहेगा यंग टीन फिर अडल्ट
ठीक है ओके जस्ट कंसीडर नाउ दिस इज ओल्ड
Yes, sir.
Just consider. Okay, just for exam, means this what we can say example point of view.
Okay.
If sir. You are in the range 41 to 70, then you are old now. Okay. So, how we can check this status? Because I am inputting my age. I am inputting age only. So I can check the status like this. If age.